Hello, my dear students. Welcome to science class. So we are continuing with the chapter body movements. So this is your chapter number 8 from your NCERT as well as your awareness book. Okay. So let's see what we are going to learn today. Today, basically, we will be learning about the movement of certain animals without legs, right? So, this includes what? This includes movement in earthworm and movement in snail, okay? So, let's begin the class. Now, we usually associate the movement with legs all the time, isn't it? But all the animals in our animal kingdom, they do not have legs. Right. So the animals which do not have their legs, they use only the muscles of their body for moving from place to place. Right. So some of these animals, it includes that earthworm. Okay. Earthworm, generally they don't have legs. Then snail, fish and snake. Okay. So today in this class, we will be describing such two animals, that is movement in earthworm and movement in snail. Right. Now, earthworm, all of you have seen earthworm. Okay, basically, where does this earthworm is found? Basically, it is found inside the soil. Okay, soil is their habitat, moist soil. Okay, now, an earthworm, it does not have any bones or leg, right? It has a muscle which helps to lengthen and shorten the body. You all know that when a muscle walks, okay, it walks by an alternative contraction and relaxation, isn't it? Okay, so earthworm also similarly, it has muscles which helps to lengthen and shorten the body, right? Now, this earthworm's body, it consists of what? Liquid filled segments or compartments which are joined together. Here you can see, these all are what? Inside actually the liquids are present, and these all are the segments, the ring-like structure which are joined together, okay? So, normally the segments of earthworm body, they are short and fat, right? And this earthworm's body, it has got two types of muscle. What are the two types of muscle it has? Number one is the circular muscle and number two is the longitudinal muscle. Okay, here you can see these are the circular muscle. Okay, and inside you see these are the longitudinal muscle, right? And these are the fluid filled segments, as I have said. Okay, fluid filled segments, they are just present outside of this muscle, that is the circular muscle, right? And inside of the circular muscle, there is what? There is longitudinal muscle, okay? So, what happens? How does it work? When the circular muscles contract, okay, then what happens? They make the segments of earthworm body long and thin, okay? Contraction of circular muscle. Here you see, this is a contraction of circular muscle. Okay, so when this is contracting, here you see what is happening. The segments of earthworm body, it is becoming long and thin, right? And when just the opposite thing happens, that is when the longitudinal muscle contract, that means this part, the orange part, okay? When this contract, then what happens? They make the long and thin segments of earthworm body into short and fat again. Okay, so by this contraction and relaxation between the alternate movement of longitudinal muscle and circular muscle, actually it makes the earthworm moves. Okay, as I said, you here you see, when the earthworm is moving, you see one time the body, okay, a part of a body, it is contracting, another part of a body is relaxing. Okay, like this way, alternately, what happens? It moves. Actually, it moves by what? It moves by lengthening and shortening its body alternatively by using longitudinal and circular muscles respectively. Right? Now, each segment of earthworm body, okay, here you see, these are the each of the segment. This is the microscopic view or the enlarged view. These are the segment. Now, each segment of earthworm body just beneath, okay, that means in the lower part, they are having tiny bristles. What are bristles? They are the hair-like structure, okay, and these are present here, you can see. These are the hair-like structure and these are present on underside of earthworm. right? Now, for what purpose these bristles are there actually? These bristles can be moved into the ground to grip the ground, as because they don't have leg, okay, and their body is what it is slippery in nature, okay. So in order to move it properly, in order to grip the ground, actually these bristles are there, okay. Now here you see how does an earthworm moves, okay. So now this is figure number A. Figure number A, what does it show? It shows the normal shape of the body of earthworm when it is stationary. Stationary means what? When it is not moving. That means it is fixed at a place. Okay. So in this position actually, all the segments of earthworm body, they are short and fat. Here you see. All the segments are short and fat and they are equal. Okay. And bristles on the underside of the body, they are gripping the ground. This one is the ground, this straight line is the ground, and here you see each of the bristles, okay, which are lying just underneath of each of the segment, they are just gripping the ground, right? Now next, figure number B. Okay, figure number B, what does it show? Now to move forward, when the earthworm is trying to move forward, this is actually the direction of the movement, okay, this. Okay, that is from left to right, right? So to move forward, what happens? The earthworm, it contracts the circular muscle of the front segment, due to which the front part of the body, it becomes long and thin. Okay, here you see the front part, it is becoming long and thin, as because it is contracting the circular muscles, right? And moves ahead by some distance. Here you see it was there earlier and it moves ahead of some distance. Okay, now during this time, what is happening? The bristles in the front part of the earthworm body are withdrawn from the ground. Now here you see they are not touched to the ground, but the back part of the earthworm body, it remains fixed to the ground by gripping action of the bristle. Okay, that means when this part is enlarging, at that time the bristles are being withdrawn from the ground. It is not gripping right now. Okay, but the back part, the bristles are gripping the ground, right? Now come to number C. Number C, here you see, in this step, the longitudinal muscles of the front part of the earthworm, it contracts. Okay, front part of the earthworm, it contracts and make it short and fat again. Here you see, the longitudinal muscle, it is contracting and it is making the segments short and fat again, right? Now, the bristles of the front part, here you see, now it is gripped to the ground. Okay, now at the same time, what is happening? The circular muscle of the back part, it is contracting and again it is making the back part of the earthworm body long and thin. Okay, and as a result, same like before, these bristles are being withdrawn from the ground, right? Now, finally what happens? Here you see number D. Finally, now the longitudinal muscles of the back part of the earthworm, it contracts, okay? And it makes what? It makes short and fat, pulling the back of the body forward. Okay. So this is how generally the earthworm moves. Okay. And in this way, actually the earthworm, it completes one step of its movement and covers a small distance, like here, from here to here, just a small distance, right? So by repeating these steps, the earthworm, it keeps on moving further. Right, their movement is very slow rather. Now the body of the earthworm, it secretes a slimy substance. Okay, slimy substance means a kind of moist, soft and slippery substance, okay, from their segment, which helps in its movement, right? Now here you see how this squeezes their muscle and they move. Okay, totally their movement, it is done with the help of what? With the help of contraction and relaxation of their body muscle, that is longitudinal muscle and circular muscles. Okay. Now next we will be discussing about another animal, that is snail. Okay. So snail, mostly like during rainy season, you will find in the moist places, like in moist ground, or you can say in the moist wall. Okay, wherever there is algae, they mainly feed on algae. So wherever there is algae in the moist part, you will find that the snails are creeping over there. Okay, so snail, you will find that they are very, very slow moving animal. Okay, and you will find the main characteristic is that it has got a shell at its back. Okay. insect has got a shell at its back, right? Now, the body, okay, this is the entire anatomy of a snail. Now, the body of the snail, it is soft, okay? This body, it is soft, okay? And it consists of head, okay? This is the head, right? A foot and shell. This is the foot and this is the shell, okay? Now, the head of the snail, it has two pair of tentacles. This is the tentacle, okay, for catching prey. Okay, now the larger pair of tentacles, it has little eyes in them. Okay, here, okay, at the tip of the tentacle, there is a presence of eye, right? Now, shell, it is the outer skeleton of snail, but it is not at all made of bones. Okay, shell contains what? Contains the internal organs of the snail. Okay, like during any kind of unfavorable condition or dangerous condition, what happens? The snail, it withdraws its head and foot into the shell, inside the shell, in order to protect themselves, as because their body is very, very soft. Okay, and it is prone to get affected quickly. Right? Now, the snail, it has only one foot under its body. Okay, only one foot. Right? Now, the foot of the snail, it is large, flat and disc shape, as you can see. It is large, flat and disc shape, which is made up of a strong muscle. Okay? And it is called what? It is called muscular foot. Right? Now, actually what happens? The snail, it moves with the help of the large disc shaped muscular foot. Here you see. This is the body of the snail, muscular body of the snail. And this is what? This is the shell. Here you can see this is a pair of tentacles and over here actually the eye is there. Okay. Now the snail, it moves with the help of the large disc-shaped muscular foot. That means this part, right? Now how does it move? There are two sets of muscle in the foot of a snail which contract and expand alternatively. As I have said you, the principle of working of muscle. Okay. Expansion and contraction. Right. So, when they move, okay, if you observe their movement, what you will find that when they are moving, in their body, a kind of wave effect from back to front is happening, okay. And these series of waves in the muscles of the foot, it is making the snail move forward, right. And it is a very, very slow movement, right. The movement of the snail, it is known as what? It is known as creeping. And one more information I want to give you, that snails are known as what? Are known as gastropod. Gastropod means what? Belly-footed animals. Belly-footed animals. That means their belly and the foot, okay, they are together. That is why they are called gastropods. Okay. And the movement is called what? Is called creeping, as I said you. So, in this way, the movement of snail is kind of similar to that of earthworm. Okay, as because in both the organism, actually what is happening, the movement is taking place with the help of muscles entirely, without bone, right? But the movement of earthworm, it is little bit faster than that of a snail, okay? So, that's all for today. Thank you everyone. In our next class, we will be learning about the movement of fish and snail. Till then, take care. Thank you everyone.